gonna do some floor work here. So start starting lower backs. We're still crooked. Bend you up. Alright, heels in, toes out. I want you to close your eyes. Bring one hand on your belly. You can bring one hand on your chest or just both to your belly. Sometimes this doesn't feel comfortable on the floor. Separate your teeth. Tongue off the roof of the mouth. Big inhale, big exhale. How quickly can we surrender the weight of the body to the earth? How quickly can we settle the mind? Take one more big inhale. Big exhale. Open your eyes. Bend up your knees. I'm just going to wrap the arms around the top of the knees. So you can grab your hands to start if you need to. If your hips are feeling good, go ahead and grab your opposite elbows just right off the bat. Tip is a little bit tight, so I'm gonna just keep a looser grip for now. What I'm gonna do is try to tuck your chin and flatten out your lower back. Let's take one more big inhale. Big exhale. Release the left leg, grab just the right leg. We'll take them out to the side. You can roll your ankle a few times with your toes. Take a big inhale. And big exhale. Release the right leg. Grab the left. Out to the side towards the shoulder. Again, move the ankle, move the toes. And pulling that knee towards the shoulder, compression in the hip. Release that left leg. Now you bring up both knees. Bend up the knees, shins parallel to the floor. Pull your belly in, press your lower back down. I'm gonna take both knees to the left. My solenoid tower's in the way. I'll turn the head to the right. Just a nice gentle supine twist here. Inhale. Big exhale. Untwist. Switch sides. Try to have your knees about in line with your belly button here. Still up a little bit high. We'll turn the head to the left. Inhale. Come on back to center. Let's keep those knees up just for a sec. Press your lower back down and make sure your knees are above your hips, not in towards your chest. All right, so it should be an active position here for your belly, for your legs. I'm gonna point the toes and just lower that leg, touch it barely to your mat, pull it back up. Keep your lower back touching. And we'll go left. And two. Three. Press the lower back down. Four. Halfway there, we got five. Six is barely touched with the big toe. Seven. Lower back down. Eight. And eight. Nine. One more each side. Ten. And ten. All right, bring the legs all the way along. Arms up over the head, stretch your belly. Alright, now let's grab just the right foot. Left hand can come onto your hip. Keep that hip down. We're gonna pull the knee towards the floor. Just getting into that hip a little bit more on the right side. Release the tension. We'll grab the big toe or the heel as we extend and open that leg up. Deep breath. Bring the leg up, bend the knee, we're gonna roll it over into a supine twist, them all the way down, and then right arm up. Turn your head, allow your body to twist and open as you breathe. Big exhale. One more time, inhale. Big exhale. Untwist. Recenter yourself back in the middle and we'll grab the left foot. Have happy baby on the other side. Again, just making sure the right hip stays down. Stack the ankle above the knee. We'll pull straight down. Try to flex your toes. Squeeze your right leg. Release the tension from there. We'll grab either the heel or the big toe as we open out to the left. I gotta scoot myself over a little bit of stuff on this wall. That's better. And right arm out, we'll turn the head. Close your eyes. Just careful with the knees, so try to keep left leg active. Squeeze it tight. All Carefully bring the leg up, right, bend that knee, roll it into our supine twist. Left arm out. And this time here, the head's turning to the left side. Both knees in, just a loose little grip here to release the back. And we're going to grab the back of the legs and we're going to rock the whole length of our spine. Just a few times. Whoa, feels nice. And then all the way up. I'm going to turn to face the front. We'll do a little separate leg stretching. So if you want a different variation of this pose that I love so much, try to do these every day. You can put your foot on top of your thigh instead of on the inside. That kind of changes the angle of the stretch there. We'll still stay squared off. My hair's going crazy. All good. Let's grab that foot. Just remember, we want all 10 fingers behind the foot, so bend the knee if you need to. And we'll hold here. Close your eyes. Stay with the breath. Allow the body to open as you breathe. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Release. Oh, my back is tight a little bit here. Again, squaring off. If we want to switch it up and put that foot on the top of the thigh, think like a half lotus. Right, the foot comes up here. My back wasn't so tight, I would do that this morning. All right, let's run on down, grab your foot. Take a moment. Just be with your breath. Don't be in a rush. Oh. Extending the right leg, we're going to bend the left leg back, so we're going to get that half fixed firm. Let's come all the way down. So all the way down if you can, and then close your eyes. Thank you. And take another big breath. Slowly come on up. Switch sides. Again, that right toes are pointing straight back. We're not sitting on the calf.
Right to the side.
And then we'll come back. All the way back. Make any little adjustments that you need to so that it's a little bit more comfortable. Take one more big breath. All the way up. Now I'm going to take the legs out wide. Oh. Little adjustments if we need to. We'll come into our straddle here. You can grab your toes and just walk the hands forward. As you inhale, try to lengthen, straighten the back. Exhale, forward fold. We're doing our best to not let the mind wander too much. More big inhale and big exhale. Ooh, let's come back up. We're going to turn around, bringing the legs together and lying on our backs. Bend up your knees. This gentle bridge pose here. You're ready to press your hips up. You can interlace your hands if you'd like, or just keep your palms flat. We'll unhook the hands and roll down. Extend the legs. Give your knees a little squeeze. And rock a little bit. And then we're going to send the feet up here. Close your eyes. And just bring your hands onto your belly for a moment. Separate your teeth. once we feel the blood coming out of the legs back down, we're going to slowly bring the legs down. Go slower than you want to. Once you're all the way down, separate your feet. Roll your head, your shoulders down your back. We're going to hold here in Shavasana for about 2 minutes together. Start at the top of the head. And relax all the muscles of your scalp, forehead, eyebrows, jaw, tongue, ears. You want to make sure lips are together, teeth are separated, tongue off the roof of the mouth. Your chin should be in a neutral position so that that throat is open. And take big deep breaths. Make sure the chest, the shoulders are relaxed. Natural external rotation in the arms, palms are facing the sky. And when the body is relaxed, the fingers should be curled in just slightly. And then making your way to your belly. Allowing the belly to just rise and fall as you breathe. Make sure your hips and lower back are relaxed. Not holding on to any tension. The muscles of the thighs, hamstrings, outer hips, all of those are just relaxed, heavy on the mat. And the knees are soft, calves are relaxed, and the toes are kind of just flopped out to the side. Start to deepen the breath. You move the fingers and toes. Pull your head. We'll keep the eyes closed as you're ready. Gently roll to one side. We'll keep the eyes closed. We'll press up. Coming back to our seated position. Tilt your pelvis forward, lift your chest, drop your shoulders. This time flip your palms to face the sky. Let's do one more big breath together. Inhale, arms up. Exhale. We'll just bow the head. Thumbs to third eye, gesture of gratitude. The light in me honors the light in you. Have a great day. I'll see you tomorrow.